Welcome back, everybody. Let's see, we've finally left that horrible, horrible frozen wasteland, and we're finally off the sea. You know, we're not much of a sea-bearing one. We like our land, so it's nice to have our feet on solid ground again. Let's see what's happening here.
What's all this about a scouting ship?
We're going to explore the outer seas. Oh, let me explain. Beyond the reaches of our kingdom lie vast, open oceans we call the Outer Seas.
And you're going to explore them? What for?
To make a map of the whole world, of course.
A map of the whole world?
That's right. Ifrit's pirates have many ambitions, one of which is the creation of a complete map describing the whole world. In fact, the Von Eltius already sailed all the way to the far continent for that very reason.
That's amazing.
You guys sure dream big.
I still don't get it.
Yeah, me neither. A map of a bunch of places nobody cares about? Big deal.
Well, regardless, if we're going to find anything in the vast waters, we'll need a lot of luck. We'd like to borrow some of yours.
And just how do you plan on doing that?
I want you to use your gut instincts to tell us where to look. In exchange, the Von Eltia will be at your service. And you can keep anything we find in our explorations. You'll be able to assign us new orders from any location by using a kind of messenger bird called a sylphjay. Who knows? We might even come across some good treasure, or maybe some rare food, or brand new recipes.
That's a lot of treasure you could find.
Doesn't sound bad to me. It won't take much of our time, and besides, it could be interesting.
You're right. Okay, as long as I'm not responsible for how things turn out, I guess I can help.
All right, then I'll tell you what you need to know.
Okay, so we have command of our ship, and all they want in return is our gut instinct. That seems pretty awesome to me. All right, so I guess we're gonna choose the Lyman Sea. Or level one, Lyman Sea, begin the voyage. Yes. Okay. We got 5 minutes for that to return.
Scout ship setting sail.
Okay. Oh, 5 seconds. Wow, not even 5 minutes. 5 seconds. That's amazing.
Take a look at this.
What have we found? Okay, we got some food. I see. Okay, so this is, I think I understand how this is gonna work. Okay, so, it's kind of funny. A lot of games have started to do that now, where they have this this thing where you just kind of like, it's a mini game almost. It's not even really, there's nothing super special about it. It's just like free items every 30 minutes or a couple of hours or whatever. Bravely Default and Bravely Second did that as well. And now I guess Tales of are doing it too. Ah! Excellent. I'm not sure where we're supposed to go, but wherever there is a cat's chest is where I will be. So, we're gonna go on 75. Wow, that was a lot of... Please give me an item. You jerk. I didn't get anything from him. Oh well. I'm sure we'll find lots more souls.
Sir, scouts have reported seeing a powerful demon. Its danger level has been classified as Code Red.
Understood. I'll notify the Abbey we have a Code Red demon in our midst. Send out an emergency alert to the neighboring areas.
Right!
With wild demons this close to the capital, the Abbey must have had its hands full.
Aizen, what did he mean by a Code Red demon?
It's like a most wanted list for demons. From the latest I've heard, there's around 10 such demons across the territories.
Oh, they sound pretty tough.
That would be putting it lightly. Suffice it to say, you wouldn't want to face one unprepared.
Then we'd best be prepared.
Let's get going. While we're wasting time here, the Abbey is digging in.
Very well! Onward to Logris!
Wait, you're coming too?
Oh boy. Oh, here we go. Souls. I almost missed these. I don't know how. What else can we do? So, I remember when I first started this game, I was complaining about Tales of Zestiria, about how the areas were way too big and there was so little in them that it was just a complete waste. And this looks a little better. It still is, it does kind of feel a little empty. But it's not I don't feel like I have all this way to walk to do absolutely nothing. So it is a lot better in that aspect, which is good. So I got two exits here. I guess we'll go this way.
Wow. Those walls. They're so huge.
That's Logris, the capital of the Empire. They keep demons out by enclosing the city within a great wall.
Humanity has achieved great things on the backs of slave Malakim.
Why the surprise, Lafayette? You've been here before, right?
I have. But back then, I was not who I am now.
I see. Tethered Malakim aren't even allowed the freedom to observe their surroundings.
We'll soon lose such freedom ourselves.
Huh?
We've reached the heart of the Empire, and of the Abbey. Soldiers and exorcists are stationed all around. This is no place for a collection of villains like us.
I'm not looking for a place. All I need to find is Artorius. That's it.
Well then, let's go find him. Okay, well, I'm not getting anywhere with this, so I guess we're just gonna run away.
Why did you come back to us?
I could tell you all missed me something awful.
We didn't, at all.
And what about your search for this traitor?
He slipped away yet again. I've no clue where he ran off to.
You're a witch. Can't you use a spell or something?
My spellcraft works kind of like a three-legged race. It simply requires my backstabbing, slippery accomplice.
Like a con artist needs an accomplice.
I am not a con artist!
I'm not going to help you find your traitor, you know.
How cold! Such an icy stare could freeze fire!
And you don't have anyone else?
Well, no.
Do you have a home to return to?
Nope.
Do you know a trade other than magic?
Nope.
What is it, Lafayette?
Magilu's story made my chest feel funny. And my nose is running.
The witch has no friends, no home, and no purpose. I think what you're feeling is pity.
Pity?
It's when you feel sorrow for someone else.
I pity Magilu.
An inspection.
They won't inspect everyone. Just act natural.
Your face is all stiff.
I know.
You, in the black coat. Show me your documentation. Well, your travel permit from the Abbey, where is it?
Foolish girl, how many times have I told you? A magician's apprentice must wear a pleasant grin.
Magician?
Verily, I present to you the traveling troupe of mischievous misfits known across the land as Magilu's Menagerie.
entertainment for the ceremony?
Why, yes, indeed we are, my dear. Please pardon my uncouth apprentice. Girl, allay the good man's fears and show him the dove trick you've spent all these weeks on. Go to...
Huh? Oh, sorry, mistress. I forgot to prepare.
You pathetic little shirker! A proper performer is perpetually prepared!
It's fine. Doves flying around would be a nuisance.
No, this will not do. If you cannot summon a dove, then act like one. Act like a dove!
Coo-coo.
Ties here. Move along.
As you say.
That was a fine ploy, Mogilu.
Well, don't expect tricks like that every day. Coo coo. Oh, that murderous gaze. Coo coo.
Those doves were amazing.
Just a crude trick. If anything, it just shows the capital's defenses are pathetic.
More like it shows how much confidence they have in those defenses. How many soldiers are here, Lafayette?
The number of exorcists in the capital? At least 1,000. And 2 divisions of guards.
I'd expect no less from the capital. They're not careless. They're covered.
We need transit documents.
See how the citizens smile? To think they were fleeing from demons just a few years ago.
To hold an observance of this scale shows just how much peace their power has brought.
A peace paid for with Luffy's...
Velvet?
And that is why I'm happy Mogilu is with us still. That was amazing, if I do say so. Alright, so I need to rest because I tried to fight a boss and it didn't go very well. It was a very tough fight. I seem to still have problems with in boss fights maintaining souls. Even if I don't use them, they seem to disappear whenever I get hit. And eventually you're left with 1 soul and then I can't do any attacks. So I'll have to figure out how to deal with that. But first... Oh, wait, I passed by our little shop here where I can rest my weary wings. So there's also some sort of ceremony going on, so I wonder what that's all about. Some of the townspeople seem excited about it, but I don't really know what's happening.
Listen to those cheers. The royals sure have these folks in line.
Subjects, may I have your attention? It is I, Percival Asgard, Crown Prince of the Midgand Empire. His Majesty, my father, and I are pleased to celebrate with you on this auspicious day.
The ceremony started. It will be impossible to slip in now.
After the opening, 10 years ago, our kingdom faced an existential threat, both from demons and the terrible spread of demon blight. However, one man raised a miraculous sword and stood so that the body and soul of the land
over there
would not be
lost.
You can
climb up if you want, but attacking now would be suicide.
And the name of that man was Artorius Colbrand.
Artorius! 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 Artorius!
None here, I trust, are unfamiliar with Artorius' noble act. To bring us salvation from demons, he sacrificed everything.
But he's a murderer.
He called Lord Innominat, one of the 5 Imperians, and blessed us with the strength of the Malachi.
But he's a murderer!
serves as a shining beacon of reason in this world of turmoil. And reason is what binds us.
But you killed him. You took everything that I loved.
So raise your voices in praise to Artorius' devoted work. To the Savior who purifies evil and guides our flock. Let us call him our shepherd.
Shepherd Artorius! Shepherd Artorius! Shepherd Artorius!
Shepherd Artorius!
Shepherd Artorius! Shepherd Artorius!
Even though the world was filled with suffering, I had to ask something tremendous of you all. I entrusted you to endure the pains of reason. I asked you to bind yourselves with shackles of your own will, for the only blade that can expel calamity is one forged from unshaking reason and the iron will to do what must be done. And now that very blade stands ready before all of us today, I offer my body and my life in service to the people of this great land. With the blessings of the Imperium Innominat, I will guide you to a world without calamity. And this world's suffering will be nothing but a distant memory!
You're the one who murdered.
Fool, they'll see us.
You're the one who killed Lafayette. What?
The Shepherd Artorius. That's who you're after?
Oh, and here I was hoping you'd just straight up pounce on him.
That would be certain death. No, I need a sword of reason and will. That's the only thing that can kill him.
Killing Lord Artorius? Playing it safe? Boring! Regrettably, it is at this juncture we go our separate ways. I've got a bit of hunting to do.
No one's stopping you.
Goodbye. Farewell! May your days be fruitful and your nights tormented!
If our enemy's calling himself a shepherd, he won't be going into hiding. Let's take this slowly.
The old man behind him. Melchior, I take it?
Yeah.
Let's gather information on these people. If we know what they're planning, we can find a weakness.
They're the most powerful men in the land. If we're going to look into them, we need a lead first.
Aizen, do you have any underworld contacts in the capital itself? Like your friend at the port?
I don't go inland much, I'm afraid. But Eifried has close ties to a shadow guild. A tavern in the city, run by an old man called Baskerville, serves as a front for them.
A shadow guild? Those sorts of things actually exist?
That settles it. Let's head to that tavern. They'll have food, I'm sure.
Why not?
Okay, so... we didn't, as I was hoping. I was hoping we would just attack him right away. That would be great. The end of the game right there. But, alas, it was not. And instead, we're going to take the slow and careful approach. Not as much fun, but probably smarter. And Magilu's gone again, which, I don't know, it's kind of sad, but I'm sure we'll see more of her. Oh yes, I'm very sure of that. What's this purple spot over here? Oh, where we're supposed to go. Excellent.
What'll it be?
Some food for the boy.
Mabo curry is our specialty. It takes a week to stew properly.
Mabo curry?
Some of that, then. Say, do you know a man named Baskerville? I heard we might find him here.
That old man? A scoundrel and criminal who went against the rules of the Abbey. They executed him long ago.
Oh.
Velvet! This Mabo curry is amazing!
You get along so well. Is he your brother?
No.
No, he wouldn't be, would he? After all, your brother was murdered before your eyes.
How do you know that?
The shadows watch those who flinch from the light.
So the guild is still active, even after Baskerville's arrest?
That's right. Just like how Eifried's crew continues their piracy, even without their captain.
So you're the contact?
What may I help you with?
I want to know what Artorius is planning.
Information such as that? It won't come cheap. I have here a list of jobs, not one remotely legal. Take care of all of them, and I'll tell you what you want to know.
Ooh, what do we want to do? Foil an ambush? That sounds like the most exciting, so let's do that first. I'm guessing we're gonna have to do them all anyway, so...
Take this with you as documentation. It's fake, but it's a good fake. It'll hold up to inspection.
It's registered to Mogulu's Menagerie?
Oh? Was that not the name you gave to the guard at the gate?
I can see you're a group to be reckoned with.
Report back here once you're finished. However, be aware that should you fail...
Then this conversation never took place. Got it. I'll cause you no trouble.
I appreciate your understanding. You're welcome to stay the night, free of charge. Forget about work until the morning comes. Right. You're missing Captain Eifried. The captain has done much toward our viability. I promise that I'll share anything I hear about him for no charge.
Thanks. All we know is there was a pendulum on the ground at the last place he was seen. And that Legate Melchior is connected to the captain's disappearance. How? We don't know.
Sounds like you've got problems of your own. Do you really have time to take on ours as well?
I could ask you why you've tied yourself up with Velvet.
Me? I've got a debt to repay. Without her, there's no way I'd have ever found my blade again.
A demon repaying a debt? Ridiculous.
As ridiculous as a pirate Moloch, you think? No matter how you look at it, there's nothing reasonable about our rogue existence. And in this brave new world governed by reason, a rogue can either rage and become a monster like me, or...
Or band together with others. Like a ship full of pirates, perhaps.
Exactly. I admire Velvet's courage, squaring off against the whole world on her own. Few can accomplish that. It takes strength. Real strength. And I'm curious where it comes from.
So you're doing it for yourself after all?
Is that so wrong?
No. I'm the same. I need allies on my side, with the strength and courage to combat this so-called order imposed by the Abbey. But anyone who's willing to put up with the creed folly of Eifried's pirates... has to be an even bigger fool than we are. So I'm like you. I want to know how deep her foolishness goes.
She'd kill you if she heard that, you know.
It's a compliment. Fools that big aren't born every day.
Uh-huh. And I imagine your dear Captain Eifried's much the same.
Aye. That man flies his fool flag proudly.
The Shepherd Artorius, He's got the populace eating from the palm of his hand. I wonder... Just how deeply will the fangs of our would-be tragic heroine scar this broken world of ours? I've got a traitor to find, but in the meantime, this should be a good show.
Alright, let's go prevent an ambush. I believe that's what we... foil an ambush. What is this? Play a serving game? I don't think I want to play a serving game. I'm okay, thanks.
So, somebody means to ambush the Royal Medical Society on the Danann Highway.
The Royal Medical Society is a group of doctors that travel around healing the sick.
They're funded by donations given by ordinary folk.
Why would anyone attack them?
Don't ask me. Some people are just twisted.
And why would an underworld group defend them?
Who knows? Something to do with the attackers, perhaps?
A kind face for such a hard woman.
She knew about me and our cover. She's got ears everywhere.
And that's not all. She called the papers fake, but they're not.
So she's got spies working on the inside, too.
I heard that her predecessor, Baskerville, was a monument against authority. To think he was executed.
They've lost their leader, but remain unconquered. Not an organization to trifle with.
That's how they have to be to take on the Abbey. We'd better succeed on our missions, and not just to get the information we need.
Yeah. Besides, I'd like to get another of those drinks, too.
You're a man of taste. That place always has the best.
You'd better work hard too, if you want more Mabo curry.
I will.
Anything for food. Finally, I found it. I was looking for this place for a little while. I found lots of souls, though, and some chests, so it's not all bad.
Hey! Get out of our way! That there! That's our food! Give it up! It's ours!
So the attackers were demons. I guess that's why they needed us to stop the attack.
The doctors?
Looks like they ran off. It appears. appears they were after this stuff.
Medicine with the cathedral seal.
That scarf, did that belong to the attackers?
Yeah, all three were wearing them. Does it mean something?
They were just humans. Aggressive ones who attacked the innocent.
Alright, so that's one quest down.
Time to leave.
We've got two more to do. Maybe we'll do that next time. For now, I think we're gonna open this box, obviously. Please get. Oh, we got a top hat. Awesome. We are very low on souls, unfortunately, now, though. But. Oh, I'm sure. What? Why can't I put it on? What? Aww. No, I like our rosy cheeks and glasses too much. Maybe we can give the top hat to someone else. Who would look good at a top hat? Is he looking good at a top hat? Oh, you can give a... Yes, we will give him a top hat. He looks great. Alright, perfect. Let's go back, collect our reward, and start on some of those other quests.
By the way, those folks we...
What were they?
They were warning each other to be careful, talking about the demons that burned down.
Considering how bold we've been, everyone...
You'll be famous soon enough once we...
Sounds like that could get...
Fun.
The people trying to capture us will put prices on our heads and put up... Depending on who draws the likenesses, each portrait can look completely different. You know what I'm...
Aye. I've seen dozens of pictures of myself. Some make me a monster, others make me a handsome youth. It's fascinating, really.
I hope I get a poster soon.
Then do your best to really stir things up.
Right. I'll stir everything up good.
I feel like we're being a bad influence on this child, but... but, you know, I guess it's probably better than what the life he had beforehand, so... What can you do?
You're good at what you do. I'm impressed. There's still more to do. I'm sure it'll be easy for you.
A scholar missing on the road to Gallus Lake.
Strange request.
If they know where he vanished, why don't they just look for him there?
Exactly. And what's so illegal about a missing persons case that you gotta go to the underworld?
I can think of a few possibilities, but our job isn't to ask questions.
Alright, so we'll finish these two quests off next time. For now, I'm going to have to end this episode. But I thank you for watching, I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, let me know. If you didn't, of course, tell me how much you hated it. Thank you for watching again, and goodbye.